Good day, Sanibona, Molweni. Here's another segment of our social media Takeover Fridays. Hi, Abongile Mbali. Hi Yanda, hi Aso Ke Uhulument. Wowza, I feel like it's a GNU collabo. Hi Anati Bapem Kochana. Hi guys, good day Molweni. Hi Anomaku. We have 2 more minutes. Then we invite our guest. I'm excited about today's guest. I hope you guys have had time to look her up so that you can have questions for her that we can ask on your behalf. Hi, Lamli Lendlebe. Yeah, give us feedback about how you liked last week's guest that we had. And guys, I just want to say, as the interview commences, please just ask your questions. Don't wait until at the end, because after our interview, we log off, right? So we're not going to get a chance after the interview then to ask questions. So if you are interested in anything that our guest says, or you want to ask questions, just write them on the comment section and then sizombuza. Hi Nomkhosi Mamncwango, oko makhohliso sivuyile Songwevu. Hi Mr. Songwevu. Hi Mkhuseli Gongwana. Hi Qiniso Mabizela. Nice of you to join us. Tandokazi Nonkazimulo. Hi, Mr. Songwevu. Hi, Manguchana. Okay, guys. Hopefully our guest will be joining us soon. Hi, Asanda Max. Hi, Singala Kadinsi. Let's check if our person has joined us yet. Okay. She hasn't joined yet. Hi, Londi Mzolo. Hi, Vuyo Faku. Hi, Vuvu. Hello, Tando Makaula. Hi, Fanin Zingo. If you're a student at WSU, I hope exam preps are going well. Hi, Kukule Tumde Nemia. Hi, Mundi Se Longwana. Siyasangavuza. No, my darling man, let's take this offline. Let's take it offline. We have the applications, admissions, and registration office, Siyasanga, that can assist you in your with your question. Hi, Kabiso Lanzela. Hi, Sis Y. Hi, Miss Yonela Mkatwa. Hi, Kawe Mangengeza. Hi, I am Sipesihle. Hello, Zizi Pombona. Noxolo Mbhalo, we see you. Okay, guys. Okay. Let's see if we can invite our guest. Hi, Sinatemba Mona. Hi, Sinukolumfaka. Hi. Oh, sorry, Sinoyolo. I beg your pardon. Hi, Ongeziwe Mchokolo. Hi, Sbahle Faki. We see you. There we go. I see our guest. Has joined us. Let's do this. Go. Hi, Mangaliso Shenane. Hi, Esetumtiki. We see you. All right. There we go. Joining. Hello! Hi, Miss Mtutimba, our Hello. Guest for today, guys. I'm very well, thank you for asking. I was getting worried because it seems like technology is not technology. These days.
Yeah, no, we're here.
Thank you so much for joining us. Welcome to our social media Takeover Fridays. My name is Andy Mafunda. So nice of you to join us. We welcome you. We live here too today as our honored guest.
That's nice.
We've got viewers who are watching. And at any point, I may have to stop and we take their questions if they have any. So I thought, let me just say that and get it over and done with. All right, let us get our interview on the road.
Okay.
Tell us, who are you?
Okay. Hi everyone, I am Nonkazimulo Mtitimba. I am born and bred in Sterkspruit, a small dusty town here in the Eastern Cape. As for my teen life, I grew up in Mthatha because my mom had to move to Mthatha because of work. That's why I did my high school and university at Walter Sisulu University. And at Walter Sisulu University, I enrolled for BSc Biological Sciences. For biological sciences. And also I want to emphasize something. I did not go into a mainstream, so they have what we call extended program. So basically a BSc degree is 3 years, and then an extended program, it's a year extra. So it's 4 years. So
Okay.
I enrolled for the 4-year program. And for
Okay.
them to determine that, we wrote tests. I don't know if you guys still do that, but there are some tests that we write. Yeah, they are more mainly on physics, biology, and mathematics. And in that test, that's
Okay.
when now they used to, maybe back in the day, then yeah, we used
Okay.
to be allocated based on our performance there. But yeah. So yeah, so that's what I did. And yeah, so the course is basically a broad, I would say it's a very broad course on natural sciences. My majors were botany, that is plants, which is what I'm going to talk about later on, plants, and as zoology, that is animals. And then also had other hectic modules that we had to do. They were very compulsory. That is your mathematics, your chemistry, your physics, your biochem, what else? Yeah, your statistics. So so yeah, so that's pretty much it. So I really have a vast and a solid background when it comes to science. Yes, and then later.
Did you always want to do, did you all, sorry, did you always want to do science at varsity, or it's something that just, you know, some people just come to varsity, they don't really know what they want to study, and then no, your marks are good, you can do, you can enroll for a Bachelor of Science. Did you always want to do a science?
So
Did you
basically,
always want to
growing
be a scientist?
up, so growing up, I had three options. I wanted one to be a doctor, two to be a an engineer. I was really fascinated about science, and then three, I wanted law. So then, in other universities, I applied for those courses, and then in WUSU, I think in NMD, I specifically applied in NMD for biological sciences. And the reason was because their requirements for mathematics is ridiculous. So so that's what I did. And then the plan was that maybe later on I will now venture into health sciences. But so I enrolled for BSc Biological Sciences, and I fell in love with the course, honestly. And I decided, no, you know what, let me finish it. And then for honors, actually, I wanted to do my honors there in WUSU. And I was specific, I wanted to work with a specific lady. She's a plant physiologist, and I was really fascinated about the plant physiology. But unfortunately, she was I think busy with her PhD at some point. So she was like, no, Lexi, I'm not taking any students, I'm wrapping up. So I was so heartbroken. And then another lecturer, she was one of my favorites, Prof. Nke. She wanted me to work with her. Unfortunately, she's lined with health sciences, so I think she was working on checking diabetes and whatnot. But then obviously in science you have to do lab tests, and for that we use rats, and so I'm really terrified of rats. So that was the only reason I couldn't work with her. But she was awesome. She was my lecturer for animal physiology. And so after my undergrad, then I was like, ugh, what a bummer. I tried Rhodes. I got accepted in Rhodes for ecology, plant ecology in botany. And then we had a FISMAS full thing going on at our university, and so I could not get my transcripts on time. And by the time the protest subsided, and they had closed for registration that side at Rhodes.
So you were stuck with the
They
rules,
had
you.
closed. And then, you know what, I honestly, I was like, no, you know what, it's some I'm a like a firm believer in God. So I was like, you know what, God has a plan for me. And then I actually taught, I was a teacher for life sciences, and for grade 10, yes, in one of the private schools in Umtata. I was a teacher for life sciences and physical science, so for grade 10, yes. And then that on for, I think it was from February until June, actually. It was from February until June. And then I got called in Rhodes by the professor that I was going to work with. She was like, hey, I've got a job for you. How about you become my research assistant? So at that time, she had a PhD student who was working on another farm, researching on speck worms. And so then I worked for that professor for a month. And then I had actually attended an interview prior to that while I was teaching. It was an arts, Department of Arts and Culture internship for a museum. So basically museums, they are also scientists. We know most, there are different scientists that look at fossils, you know, different mm-hmm. animals, evolution. You know, museums are all about restoring and capturing history, be it in science or anthropology-based history. Mm-hmm. So I was in the natural sciences. So I then had quit at Rhodes and then enrolled for the internship for arts and culture. That was 2016 at Albany Museum in Grahamstown. And then that's now where my career actually, I would say a solid career started. After an internship, I was hired as their research assistant as well. And then thereafter, I then noticed that actually I'm doing work for researchers, you know. So I was like, no, it's time for me to grow, because really with just a degree in science, I will only, you know, just do lab stuff, you know, maybe assist students in the lab. I will not have an opportunity to collaborate with the professors and whatnot. So then I approached my HOD then, Dr. James, and then I told her about it. And I it was since I had said that we looked at, you know, evolution, species and whatnot. So I then we developed a project for my honors. It was on taxonomy, and then I incorporated DNA barcoding, which is a really fancy technology. Yeah. So I'm sure a lot of people, they are familiar with DNA barcoding for maybe paternity tests, but we also do this with animals and plants for species identification. So yeah, so I got training and then that project, it was in collaboration with SAEB, one of the institutions in the country for science, natural sciences. They focus mainly on aquatic. So my project was on aquatic invertebrates. And then I had to choose another second project, because in Rhodes, it was compulsory to have two research projects. So the department is basically conjoined, yes, it's a zoology and an entomology. So I had one zoology project and I had one entomology project. So the second one was on food chains. And with that, I also tried to gain a skill that is stable isotope. So it's also one of the fancy technologies in natural sciences that is used for a lot of things in ecology. But my main focus was basically checking their diet. And to be able to work out the food chain as to who eats who. Who is at the top of the that system, and how do they interact? So that's what I did, and then I got to publish that paper in an international journal. So So after that, after completing my honors, I then worked for Sunbee. I then worked for Sunbee, and then I also got motivated to do my honors. So with my DNA
at Rhodes
still.
Wait. Before you elaborate further, I need to know, like, where do you get the time for all of this? Like, it feels like, never mind the fancy terms, it's fine, we can live with that. But where do you get all the time? You are saying that you had to have two research projects. I mean, so now your life is just about academics, basically.
It was academics. It was really tough. I mean, that year was really tough. I did not have any social life, to a point I even got dumped that year. So, you're probably seeing someone fancy in Rhodes. So it was a person that I was seeing during my undergrad there at Walter Sisulu throughout my undergrad. And then after that, I worked, we're still seeing each other. And then it was like, no, you probably have someone fancy there. So I did not have time. Honestly, I did not have time. Yeah, their honors program is hectic, truly, truly hectic, because you also have like classes to attend, tutorials, assignments. It's basically more like undergrad, but with a much, I don't know, a lot of workload.
Okay,
Yeah.
so currently what are you currently doing? What are your responsibilities where you are currently?
Currently, actually, I'm full time with my business. So my work with Sunbee was completed last year, and with my master's degree as well. So
Okay.
one of the projects that I worked on, I then had a fantastic supervisor that we had to work something around so that it could develop into my master's project. So yeah, so that's pretty much it. And so last year I did environmental DNA, like for my honors environmental DNA. You get DNA from air, soil, water. It's a new technology as well. So I had to get my hands on that. So just to be safe in the natural sciences field, all the scarcities, I make sure that I acquire them. So it's still a new technique. A few people, there are a few specialists in the country, even internationally. So it was really wonderful to do that. And then currently I'm focusing on my business. So I'm full time on my business. It has grown, and there's also an option. So I'm not just manufacturing my own products and selling them digitally, but I'm also manufacturing for people, because what I've noticed actually was that people want to start their own brands. So I had an option when I started out. I had an option of people buying my products, signature products, at discounted prices, and then they sell them, more like having distributors, you know. And then yes, so I only had a few that did not really go as I had thought, but I got a lot of inquiries for people that were like, "Hey, Ngazi, I've got a saloon and I would love to sell my own products. So, can we work something out around that?" So since I was busy with my master's, I had put that on hold. And then this year I've been full blown into private, it's called cosmetic private label. That is people who want to start their own skincare or hair care brand. They go to manufacturers and formulators to manufacture for them. And then we work around that, and then they sell, and then they brand them. So yeah, so that's what I do, and people are keen on that. So that keeps me on my toes, actually. Yeah.
So what how has your degree from WSU assisted you now in this journey of yours in your business?
Yes. So actually, I'd say so. I have eczema and psoriasis. So for that, I really used to use really expensive creams, you know, and it really did not I would say it didn't really do much on my skin, actually. So to a point where I had to now change products, and then they were really, really expensive. And then as of 2017, I started now using my skills and knowledge. So there was a module in Walter Sisulu. It was taught by the late lecturer. So I'm not sure if you guys still there, but it's called economic biology. So with that, we incorporated our knowledge in plants, in your biochem and chemistry, and then we tried to and then we learned how they actually work for different reasons. It's skin, you know, food, like different types of things, honestly. So with that, I was like, huh, actually I had learned about plants that heal skin from Mr. Kwaye in economic part. How about I do that? And so I then worked on sourcing those ingredients and trying to kind of experiment on myself. And then as soon as I got the perfect formula, then that's when I started to stick on my own. And then I had not thought of at that time about opening my own business. So I was just like, I have actually, but I'm not active anymore on that page, where I now teach people about different types of skin and what type of what is it? It started in 2018. So what type of plant-based products they can use. So really, and I would recommend other brands and you know, but then with my own, I did my own, and then I did it for, I formulated for myself and my family. And then as of 2020, that's when now I started to have that idea, but then there was no lockdown and whatnot. So things were a bit hectic. But then during that period, I did my research on sourcing, where I can source the, get the ingredients, the high grade quality plant-based ingredients. And like your shea butter, so shea is not grown in South Africa. It's grown in West Africa. It's a West African plant, but it is so good on the African skin, actually. So then I had to check that and see if I source from West Africa or what. And then I saw that I would have a lot of hurdles and admin. And then I got a certified supplier based in Cape Town that has been running for more than 10 years that is sourcing those type of ingredients from West Africa and then bringing to South Africa. And bigger brands that I won't mention, they get that from her. So I'm one of the small businesses that get the ingredients from her. So so I used the lockdown period just to research where I can source my ingredients, the type of machines that I can get to manufacture so that I can sell. And then early 2022, then that's when I kicked off and started selling, and it has been really going.
Okay. You are mentioning scarcity in terms of the products or the items that you use to actually get to your finished product.
Yes.
That sounds like it. How have you overcome? Okay, maybe let me start by saying, what have your biggest challenges been? Not just in your business, but also career as well, and how have you overcome
the challenges in my career? Let's start with career. So I'm just going to be honest with someone. So if you are going to enroll for natural sciences, please make sure that you love academia. This is an academic type of a degree. So if you enroll in your likes of your biological sciences, your likes of chemistries, physics, you just have to go. So that's part of the challenge, because with just a degree, there's high chances of you not actually getting an employment, because the degree in itself is a more academic and research-based degree. However, I'm not saying you cannot get a job with a degree. You can. Various departments, even in the country, can work for your Department of Environmental Affairs, research institutions, your universities. Now, universities have also, upped their requirements for qualifications. Back in the day, for you to be a lab assistant, a diploma or a degree was just enough, because all you do, just assist the professor, the lecturer, and you have a solid background in that in that course. So that's all. But these days, you get, job requirements are ridiculous. They want masters for lab assistant, not even a lecturer. Now lecturers, they tell you they want 5 years of PhDs now. So nice. So I would say it's no longer like in the olden days. I would say maybe. Yeah, a lot of people weren't really going up that high when it comes to academic ladder, but now a lot of people have PhDs, so they just up their game. So if you'd love to enroll in this, make sure that you love your books and you'd go for honors, at least honors or masters, and then you'd get work for research if you really love being a scientist and a researcher. But then, other than that, that's it. And then when it comes to my business, like I said, some of the ingredients that are very, very good and nourishing on the skin are not locally grown or naturally grown in South Africa. So they are sourced from other parts of Africa, So I tried. So that was a hurdle. But then I did get the secondary supplier supply. That is someone that buys from those countries and then she supplies in the country. So for us, we then buy it from her. And I would say one of the things as well is that the cosmetic machines are ridiculously expensive. So with the fund, they are ridiculously expensive. So at this point, I then try to, I mean, I've got, you know, it's a smaller one, but quite pricey as well. But it means at this point, I'm a small scale manufacturer in terms of, you know, production. I don't produce a lot. So it's just maybe small portions. When I say small, I'm talking about maybe 50 to 100. That's small. So at this point, but then we look for, we are aiming for growth so that we are also available on the shelves, because trust me, in these stores you can't be saying no, I'll give you 5 products. It needs to, you know, so volume wise, I'm aiming for there so that my products can be available in retail markets. But for now, it is on my social media pages. That's when I'm advertising. And honestly, people are going digital these days. People are buying everything online. So I wouldn't say I struggle just because I'm selling online. No, I'm not. The technology is, it's at my advantage at this point. So so I can, I'm operating from my home. So I've converted one of the bedrooms into my lab and office. So so I'm able to save one on rent. So when I save on rent, I'm able to save for those bigger, fancy, expensive machines, so that it helps me to produce even more in larger quantity, so that I qualify now to for my stuff to be on retail stores. But for now it's digital. So I'd say not having larger machines is also quite of a challenge, but we're growing.
Okay, so Nkazi, this platform, the university is using it as a recruitment space, mm-hmm. right? And we have watching potential students who are interested to study at Walter Sisulu University. What is the one piece of advice you wish someone would have given you before you embarked on your academic journey at WSU that you would like to give to someone who's considering WSU as an institution of choice?
Well, I would say University of Wosu, guys, it will teach you survival of the fittest. You are not going to be weak when you study there. It is survival of the fittest, literally in everything. Yes, in everything. For you to get, you know, these days, I mean, you guys are digitally. Back in the days, we had to hand deliver our application forms and then you sign a book. And then they had a register or something like that where you now, and then next time you are there, you're like, no, my, what is it? The results, the matric results are out and you're just going there to check for your status. And then they're like, no, we can't find you in the system. So you have to do everything, you know. But I mean, it has upgraded. It has really, really upgraded. So I would say, yeah, it has really upgraded a lot. I mean, I the first time I got there, we did not have Wi-Fi at Wosu. That's why I'm saying survival of the fittest. We did not have Wi-Fi, but we made it. We passed, and we, in our workplaces, we are one of the competitors or competent employees. So you can imagine with that, with the little that we had. I mean, now the library has extended. Back in the day, it was quite tiny. And I'm saying back in the day, guys, I that for me was in 2015. So that for my 20.
That's not long.
I mean, that's like how many years? 9 years ago.
That's, but you're looking at the at the development of the institution since then? Like, a lot has been done, I'm sure.
A lot has been done. There's Wi-Fi. Well, wait, by the time I left, there was Wi-Fi. I think there was Wi-Fi in 2014 and 15. Mm-hmm. So that was when I was doing my third and fourth year, and then I had to go mm-hmm. out. But, you know, so we made sure we had literally everything. We had one computer lab, which was in CLPD. At 4:30, it closes. I had, classes from 8 to 5. BSc Biological Sciences is a really, really, you need to love your books when you do that course. So you really need to love your books. It is, like I said, it is a hectic course. I think that's how I survived my honors enrolls, actually, because I was used to the pressure. It also prepared me so much. It prepared me so well. So at that time, imagine your classes, is they start at 8 and then they end at 5. Most of us, we have practicals from 2 to 5, so 3 hours practical. Mm-hmm. By the time you go out and you are keen to do you type your assignment, they have closed in the CLTD. So I do not have a laptop. I had to borrow from friends until my mom actually bought me a laptop. So on my second year I had a laptop, but the whole first year I did not. So I had to make friends, you know. I made sure I looked for friends that had good resources, so then I had to make time, you know. So it really teaches you resilience. It teaches you hard work. There's just a lot of you in the class. For a lecturer to notice you, you really need to do well. So unlike in those prestigious universities where there's just 20 students in class. So we became 20 as we went up, because a lot of people, they dropped out. It is a social suicide course. I mean, they dropped out to do other courses, you know, to enroll for other things. And they passed it. They are doing quite well in those things. I mean, people are doing, they've went from science to law, to social sciences, various stuff, and then they do well. So science, if you are keen in enrolling for biological sciences, be it, even if it's not biological science, as long as it's a BSc degree, I think you really need to make sure that you love your books. We know that in varsity, obviously, you need to socialize. So yes, a bit of social life there and there, just to balance things out. A bit of going out there and there, but not every weekend, because trust me, it will be hectic. It will be hectic. So yeah, I would say it really prepared me a lot. And it is also a vast, It's a really broad course. It's a really broad course, unlike other universities. I've noticed that through my journey in academia and science. A lot of people in other university, they start specializing in undergrad, you know. You'd get someone who's doing BSc botany, and then they've got maybe something else going on, and then BSc whatever. But for us, you do everything. So that puts you really in a good spot for you to specialize in various departments or in various research fields. For example, look at me. I worked in botany. I worked in zoology. I worked in I've had like genetics and whatnot. So it is really a broad, a vast background. I mean, some graduates even went to other universities to pursue their honors in biochemistry, because we do biochem in undergrad. So it is a really nice broad course that will really give you a wide range of options, one for work, one for your postgraduate studies. So yeah, so I really recommend, and it's so limna for doing my undergrad in Warsaw. I'm not saying this like my friends, no. And we there are some friends that are also in Rhodes, you know, that are peaceful. Like, we boast, we know. I mean, you give us a biology, we will nail it, you know. But there are people in their undergrad, they did not do that at all, coming from these prestigious universities. I'm not going to mention, but I'm saying that they did not. So it was quite, you know. So you'd guess I was like, no, I didn't do biochem. I was doing like botany. For us, you did everything. In fact, they now stop being called the biological science. It should be natural sciences, because everything in natural science, they put it there. Then for honors, that's when now you start to choose, okay, Dingatini, but it's a really nice broad course. So I love it. I love it so much. Yeah.
So you would say that undergrad really prepares you for when you go to honors now, where you decide on what field of specialization you want to go into. So at least by the time you get to honors, you have a broad, at least initial knowledge.
Exactly. Of interest, exactly. Right? Look, let me tell you, graduates from Walter Sisulu, they are now in paleontology. Paleontology is fossils, because they have, right, like majority of, I mean, guys, it's a lot of modules. Honestly, it's just too much, but it is really worth it. It's really worth it. So I highly recommend it when it comes to undergrad. I didn't do postgrad there, so I wouldn't say much on postgrad studies, but for undergrad, it's really a go-to if you are keen in biological sciences and you just want to get a broad, you know, spectrum or, you know, knowledge, and then now narrow down when it comes to your postgraduate, and then you're like, you know what, I think I'll do my honors in biochem. You qualify to do your honors in biochem, you qualify to do your honors in botany, in zoology, in physiology. There are people who did you know, BS, now they are physiologists for in health sciences field, you know. So yeah, because we also do animal physiology. So it is really a good, it's a really packed good course, but you have to love your books. You really have to love your books. Yeah.
Now, Ngazi, I'm sure you do have memories from just being a student at WSU, whether in class or whether socially. Could you share with us some of those memories that you have of WSU?
Some of the memories I have, it was one of the lecturer, well, we understood, before she became a lecturer, she was a high school teacher. So okay. Had a lecturer, and we, like, every time we like with my friends and I would talk about, like, la mama, can you imagine why Patrosso as a class in, she would literally hit us, la mama Loana. She was our plant taxonomy.
In a lecture hall.
Lecturer, yeah. Uswazi, for botany, we were taught in labs, so they've got labs. So that's where we attended our lectures in the labs, yeah, lab classrooms. So yeah, so la mama really hit us. If you did not know the answer, she would tell you next time. Write down the question and the answer 50 times. But it really made us to do well. Another thing is that one of the lecturers, the late Mr. Kwai, he loved calling out E-marks in class. So like, Ditimba, 0 out of 50. So you'll really get embarrassed for, you know, for failing. You'll try next time, I can't be. And then they will tell you, oh, all you do ne is slaying, but you don't love your books. Well, let's see your beauty.
So you got it.
Yeah, so I would say that also pushed us, because who wants to be laughed at by their class in, you know, and they see you on weekends partying, and then when the marks are called out, you are now getting zero. So that was really quite funny, but it really also kept us pushing, and yeah. So yeah, it was really nice.
What advice would you give to students who are interested in combining science with entrepreneurship?
Ooh, that's lovely. That is lovely. I mean, you know, these days, when I would say, due to our economy, I think even in developed countries, actually, people are really motivated to start businesses. One, you know, for financial security, second stream of income, you know. So I would say it is really, really nice. You know, studying businesses, normally, since one of our who did law, they would do their degrees, and then when they are done, they would open their own law firms and practices. And then for doctors, they would do, you know, they would open their own surgeries. So, you know, it is, people have always been business-minded, but it would really be nice to see someone or one natural science to actually, you know, to start their business with what they had actually learned, the skills and the knowledge that they acquired in their degrees. So I truly, truly love it. And I mean, yeah, it provides you with financial stability. You would get to even employ other people, you know, provide jobs for other people. So that's what I'm aiming at. Yeah, so that's what I'm aiming at for growth, to groom and hire people from even with natural science background, be it your biological sciences, your chemistries. I need chemists as well in my lab. Mm-hmm. So it would really be nice. So that's what I'm looking at. So I think really being business-wise, Google, even with our government when it comes to job creation. So definitely. Yeah, so I would really love to make that difference. So I'm aiming towards that angle.
What are some of the skills have you taken away from being a student at WSU studying BSc that you have now infused and are making use of in your business today?
Not giving up, guys. Really not giving up. I would say the course itself is really stressful. So it has, there was a time I remember my mom and I was like, I remember at some point, it's really tough and it's hectic. There was a point, actually, I'll be honest, in first year, I failed the second semester chemistry. And I was so stressed coming from a high school where you do well. Yeah, that kid of money hours, the price giving. Mm-hmm. And then varsity shows you flames and you fail a module. So there was a point I was like, yo, I think I'm in the wrong course here. And then I told my mom, but yo, mama, I think if you had actually allowed me to go to AUJ and be a radiographer, I think maybe this would not have happened. And my mom was like, you are right where you are supposed to be. But it's too much because that SFT were a University of Johannesburg for radiography. But then due to, you know, family stuff and whatnot, so I could not go, and then I enrolled at WSU. So I was like, you see, if I had went there, this would not have happened. Focus on my tongue and scanning and doing x-rays.
So basically you thought you were the exception and you were not.
You know? And yeah, it really taught me not to give up, because I really wanted to throw away my towel and just give up and maybe change courses. Also, my mates were changing courses. I was like, yo, if you have pressure, they were changing courses. People went from natural sciences to other parts and health sciences. And obviously they did well when they went to health science. So like, this course is the one that is the problem. So now I changed. I have to. My mom was like, "You're not going anywhere. You will finish." Often when the low cost area was out, I looked at below. You can listen. But I mean, and then you know what? And then I was like, you know what? Actually, for me to pass the chemistry, let me try and be friends with chemistry students. So they were chemistry major students. So then you know, became friends with some of those people. Some of them have their PhDs now. They helped me in camp, and then I passed it really, really well. So so I passed that camp. I was like, oh, God, I'm done.
You've always been networking somehow.
Yeah, so I love
whether
that.
Whether it was intentional or not.
Yeah.
So you've always been that girl who would network.
Yes, you know, being talkative and being friendly and nice to people, it really warms people's hearts. And then, you know, people are always keen to help. Trust me, as long as you open up and treat people well, they will return the favor to you. So that's how I did it. And then when it comes to estates, oh my goodness, for first year, first semester stats, I passed with a distinction. Second semester, now I saw my graph going, getting 50s. One test, I was like, yo, I need. And then there were these students that, you know, did quite well. I think they were become accounting students. I don't know about psych. So there were guys, I was like, I want to be friends with those guys.
Yeah.
I managed to pass and get my second distinction again instead because, so, yeah. So, I mean, I think hard work in WUSU, like I said, WUSU teaches you resilience and hard work. Otherwise, and honestly, lecturers nazo, they are dealing with a lot of students. So it's not like one of those smaller Nyan universities where you can chit-chat, sit down for a whole hour with your lecturer. They will tell you, attend the tutorial. Still, glad tutorial, okay? So, so you need to mingle with your peers, you know, you need to mingle with your peers. So that's what I did. And then maybe I'll say to, you know, some guys, you know what, I'll be cooking, man. I'm glad, gently, how about practice any meds, you know, and then I'll pick up. So, you know, and then we'll sit in my room and then we'll just practice and practice until I pass. So, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because what do you say to a student who is probably in grade 11 or who is in matric, what should they be focusing on whilst they're still at school in preparation for a career in not only biological sciences but any career that they choose in science?
In science. The focus is mathematics, guys. I mean, science. Really, from what I've noticed, honestly, for even if you can get, let's say, distinction, maybe in your life sciences, physics, but if you fail maths, let's say get maybe 30% maths. Metric wise, you have passed, but diversity wise, you won't be able to enroll for a science thing. You'd need to go maybe fix your marks in your mathematics. So yeah, so just try to balance things out. Make sure you work really hard and be open-minded, you know, research more on e types of courses, talk to people, talk to students that enrolling in particular. So courses are not the same, actually. That's what I found out. So if you'd love to do your BSc biological sciences, for example, don't try and get an advice from someone. I'm making an example. A-Roads. I'm going to make an example because that's where I studied. Courses are not the same. That's what I've noticed. They are called the same, but they are not the same. So in some universities, BSc Biological Sciences, they don't do mathematics. Also, you will do your maths.
Sure.
In some universities, they don't do your stats. Also, use our sense stats. So it's compulsory. It's not an option. You are going to do it. So try and get, you know, research more on your course on the particular university that you'd love to enroll in. If you'd love to enroll, let's say, in your in WUSU, try and get someone that can tell you more on the course rather than talking to someone, making an example, AUJ. They might really, the courses are not the same. That's what I've noticed. The majors are the same, but the extra things are not the same. So, for example, biological science is standard in all universities. You'll do your botany and your zoology and your chemistry, that is a standard. But iwusu, you do your maths. Iwusu, you do your biochemistry. Iwusu, you do your microbiology. In other universities, they do have microbiology, but then you have to enroll for BSc microbiology and biochem. So just try to do research with particular university. So if you are keen to do your BSc at WUSU, just try and seek information. And also, I mean, you can reach out to me. It's fine. I'm always keen to help and advise where I can.
Before we wrap up, I'm seeing comments here from people who are watching us. There's, I think, Ngumama Uthuli Sipambo. She is
a supermom. That's my mom.
She's singing praises. Ukuba, that's my girl. Super proud of her. You're resilient. You know, I have Miss Yonela Mukachwa, who's saying that she's also super proud of you. So I think people see you. You might not know it, but people see you.
And
people are following your journey. Before we wrap up, you mentioned that BSc is a is an academic qualification, yes, if I may put it that way. However, it doesn't limit you from getting a job elsewhere outside of academics. What are some of the jobs that a BSc graduate would most probably apply for?
Okay, so one, when you're done with your BSc Biological Sciences, they now look, I mean, they are post-squid game reserves, game and wild reserves, because they, you need to have a solid background on the animals. Game reserves, they are wild animals, they're lions, whatnot. So yeah, you can get a job there. I've seen posts that actually want J umdu with just a BSc clean, your undergrad, you're good to go. Your departments like your environmental affairs, they do want people with biology and environmental sciences with just your degree. And then what else? Also teaching in schools. Teaching in schools, yeah. And there are also these prestigious, very expensive high school in the country. So when you have EBSC, you they really like for you to teach science, they're like, no, you are the solid scientist for us, so you'd even get you know, but it's always advisable for people to teach. Government always encourages that, at least have if you don't have a non-education degree, get a PGCE. But yeah, so you could do that. I mean, there's various ones. In particular, where I worked, arts and culture, yeah, now ufuna ube na masters, but they offer an internship for people, okay, with just your degree. So yeah, yeah, minimum is just degree or honors, and then that's for an internship. So you can also work for arts and culture. Arts and culture, in museums, as a natural science, you know, historian, whatever. But yeah, so, but then for them now to hire you permanently, you need to have your master's so that you are now a qualified curator, minimum of master's. So I'll say, hence I'm saying the BSc degrees are more on the academia side, because good, well-paying jobs are now available massively. As you go up the ladder in academia with your master's and your PhD, you can be a researcher, you know, a lecturer, you know, yeah, all of those things. So you could still get a job, honestly, but yeah. So I do recommend also if to be open-minded when it comes to having a business, you know, to be open-minded. Okay. I there's also another guy, I think, I'm not sure if he's still is with his studies, he's a chemistry student there at Walter Sisulu. He formulated and he basically developed his own sneaker clean.
Oh yes.
Yeah. Yes. So I mean, he's a chemist, you know, you know what chemicals to mix with what to formulate, or what if you want a bar soap, you know what in the demand with this one, if you want a detergent, a liquid one, a powder one. So he just, while he was busy with his Nanzika, his studies, he developed that product. So even if, you know, as soon as maybe he's done and still thinking about maybe pursuing postgrad or looking for a job, he still he has that to keep him on, to keep him going when it comes to having an income and earning a living, you know. So I would say we really need to be now open-minded when it comes to business. Also, one thing I forgot to mention, you could also work a what do they call it, but yeah, it's the what is it, environmental surveyors, you know. And you could also work, yes, for environmental managers. So in these big construction companies, developing, now you get to go, then you'll be like, okay, this site, it's full of really their species. So I suggest mhlambi if isebenzisa le ndawo, I suggest that we now restore this ecosystem elsewhere, so we move, say, payana. So those are environmental managers. You don't need to have only environmental science degrees, even people with biological sciences, because as long as you have background in plants and environment and animal species, you're good to go. So yeah, environmental officers and managers for construction companies or development. So let's say they're about to build you now go and survey that land and be like, no, unje nakanje apha, there are these species, so I suggest mhlambi this rehabilitate elsewhere. Okanye apha, can you bonus, sometimes even in malls there are plants and whatnot.
Yes.
And we think that's sometimes for aesthetics. That's not for aesthetics, actually. That's for now. This is a special aloe plant that is indigenous in South Africa, and it's endangered because abantu bayisebenzisa kakhulu. So you'll find that mhlambe esikoneni, even if we parking lot, it's there. So it's just to restore the species. So environmental officers and managers are responsible for that. So I forgot to mention that point. Ukuthi, you could also work for that. Different companies, even some construction companies, they do hire abantu abanjalo.
Okay. We have Ubongani Nyanga East, who says, I'm proud of you, Kazi. I'm watching you with my colleagues, and they are interested in your products. So,
thank you.
I also have a Dr. Gugule Tumia. I think he's one of those chemistry students.
With my chem. Yes.
He says he's sending a shout out, and he says he sees our time is up. However, I would like for you to give any last words or thoughts that you'd like to share with the Walter Sisulu University community.
I think it is really, really great, and especially now that it's on social media, we get to reach a lot of people in terms of, you know, viewers and whatnot. I mean, everyone can just click on the page and see this. Hopefully, I think this video will be stored in the in your feed, right? This live video. I think she froze, but yeah, I'd love to thank Walter Sisulu for this. So I think this is a really great series that you guys have, and yeah, it really opens abantwana that are looking for I think I get distracted because Usisi has frozen. Let me ask. Can you hear me?